boring, but it gives us the opportunity to trade for a whole bunch of money. I just want to head up there. Basic goal here is just to be able to get enough money to base up, and then we're gonna take on some of the harder elements of Yiprit. Right now we're on the West Island. We'll be heading north to northwest section, and then we'll be going over to the East Island and exploring over there. There are a bunch of areas on Yiprit that were, I want to say, semi-developed the last time I played, and I know they've done updates to the map and updates to this particular server, Barnowl, and quite bluntly, I'm feeling pretty good about getting based up and surviving on this server, so I need to, once we get a base going, space between the two. Now I'm still pretty far south, so I haven't run into any wolves or any bears yet. I have heard lots of livestock out here. Deer and elk are everywhere. Alright, they call it a buck, but it's actually an elk. But the Zeds are quite nasty down here. I actually really like this server. Given it doesn't have its challenges of PvP, it is more about survival by hunting and fishing and that type of thing, even with the traders. Livestock, meaning the wolves and the bears, are plenty tough. The AI is plenty tough. But it's a really good way to learn the map. And I personally find Yiprit very, very enjoyable as far as the map is concerned. Doesn't get the views, you know, I mean, it's not PvP, so it doesn't get the huge amount of views that you get with the really high-end, high-pop PvP servers that a lot of people play, the day one servers and stuff, and quite honestly, I'm just not good at PvP. I love the game, but I'm just not good at it the first year. Since I started when the Lonely came out, I had never heard of DayZ until the DLC was released, and I went, I wonder what that is, and started looking it up on YouTube and stuff and saw people playing. That's when I was hooked on DayZ. The first 8 months of playing was some fun, but unless I paired up with somebody, I usually was just, you know, the freshie that everybody was shooting at. I didn't get to enjoy the base building or any of that unless I was hooked up with another group. And if you'd like to play solo, and I enjoy playing solo and exploring the maps and stuff, sometimes PvP can be a lot more frustration than it's worth. I've got, like I said before, I'm sure I've said it in one of my other videos, I've got a couple of friends that started playing DayZ and they were enjoying it. And they got into PvP and within months they were onto a different game and haven't been back to DayZ. They just get sick of the KOS. So. I hope everyone stood out there and the New Year's treating them right. Watching a lot of Altaria and Namask meds. For whatever reason, Namask, Jungle Namask especially, has picked up a lot of traction again. I mean, there was a while there where I was playing on some of the PvP servers for Namask, and it would be hours between an interaction with the other people, there's just like nobody around, and of course, with the development of Bitterroot and that whole thing going on. I'm going to delete this marker. Alright. Because I really only want to come into the north side. Somebody's already been here this morning. Huh? Well, the server restarted, kicked me off about 3 minutes after I logged in. Stab vest. CR mag? No, Glock 17 mag. What am I carrying now? I'm carrying the 45 and the Deagle, right? I don't think you can sell a tactical light poster though. Christine, how are my boots doing? Christine, I like the black boots better though. Spooky. You have to reload the blaze, that's unusual. Oh, I missed him twice. Should have hit him. Yeah, now you get over here, huh? Now we get our storage bag. Alright, we went through there, right? Now let's look at some of these ads. Ooh, what's he got on? Oh, a hat. Yay! Just looking for ammo on these guys. Usually some of them have ammo on them, but this time, no. Well, I kind of like the fact that they all have ruined hats. Five. up, my character's wicked shaky this morning. Look at that. Another aim point. And ammo. Never a bad thing. I am actually kind of surprised that when the Yiprit map came out, it didn't make more of a quote unquote splash. M16A2. Not a fan of the flickering. More ammo over there. And up there. That I can go down here. Right. So I just replaced half the ammo I used, which is always a good thing. Unless you're picking up more ammo than you're using, right? Still had the MVG strap, I didn't realize that. Nine by nine. Not sure if I should take the scope. I'll probably take it so I can sell it. Huh. considering how many AK-74s I picked up yesterday here. Bison and 45 APC. Never a bad thing. I will throw the bison down here. There's my tent. Will not let me approach. Or lay down, there we go. Over there? Nothing. Okay. Am I like stuck in the doorway or something? What the hell? Okay, this is interesting. I can't get out. Get out now. Not really. That was weird. Probably be dumping that bison fairly soon, I have a feeling. Oh my god, another field pack. Aimpoint 2000. You could do more than 80 in a stack for that. I did not know that. and ammo. What is that? Skull mount kit. I have no idea what a skull mount. It must be for the animals. Trophies. 5.56. Yes, yes, yes. Can't put on optics on it? That's weird. Okay. Oh, it did put it on it. It put it on the 74. Okay. Either way, it works. Soda. M4 bayonet, huh? I know, does anybody actually use the bayonets as bayonets on their guns? I do not. I don't think I've ever actually seen anybody that does. Ooh, another lockpick. Obviously, the combat sites are really all over the place. I actually saw a my local gun shop here in town. I actually saw a Ruger, the 9mm carbine. I can't think of it. It's the PC. Carbine, maybe? 9mm carbine. I actually saw one that had that actual optic on it. I was very, very surprised, to say the least. To say the very, very least. Kind of blew my mind that it was an actual real thing, because I'd never actually seen one before, and that it was actually set up on the and it was the older version of the carbine, not the current or the newer version. Down. What's that, a bison stock? 74. Okay. More of that, which I have someplace. Maybe I put that up here? No. Okay. This Is that the right mag? Yes, it is. Okay. So first, let's put this down here. Actually, I really don't have any reason to reload the mag, do I? Should unload it, though. That doesn't work either. Another field bag. Holy shit. That's it though. Okay. Last one. Actually like the Baraka sights. I'll take that. I guess you can never have too many knives, right? I'll take that too. Can't see where his head is. There it is. Another M16. Alright. I don't think I can carry it, can I? I can if I dump the bison and move stuff around. I want to keep all the suppressors I can. How's that? Crossbow bolts, which I will not use at this time. Bison will fit in there, but the... Nope, that won't fit. Shit. Alright, well, we'll just have to come back for it, I guess. Didn't get a lot of 5.56 ammo this time, which surprised me. Shh. to get something to munch on, aren't I? Yep. So if I can afford the tent and the pack. Get back to the trader, I'll take 5 and refill my coffee and start thinking of a plan. Just take a look at the map and see if we can find some place to base up. I marked the old base spot. It was a really good spot for making a base, but I don't know. I'm also thinking about how I should probably set up a stash down somewhere close to the western spawn. I'm also thinking about breakfast. crater. And we're just gonna hold tight here for a minute while I go refill my coffee. And I will be back. Hey, while I'm gone, hit the like or subscribe if you would. Leave a comment. Let me know how you liking things. All right.